Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to my channel. My name is Nelly. If this is your first time seeing this face, you're absolutely welcome to this space. So before we continue today's video, I would just like that you hit the subscribe button and you also hit the bell button so that you get notified each time I post a new video. So in today's video, I'll be doing something slightly different from what I always do on this channel. So today's video is like a discussion. So it's a discussion video. So in today's video, I have a topic and then I'll just be interviewing people to hear what they have to say regarding the topic. So there's been this discussion going on social media regarding paternity tests. So I took the conversation from social media and decided to bring it to my friends so that they could give their points of view about it. So if you want to hear all what they had to say, then keep watching.
Hello.
Hi.
So recently there has been a discussion going on online about paternity tests. So there was a man who discovered that he was raising two kids who were not his kids.
Oh my God.
And he made some men just say that, okay, maybe it should be like a normal test. Mm-hmm. So like when you have a baby, just like they do other tests when the baby is born, paternity test should also be a part of it so that in case the baby is not yours, you know from the first day and you know what you're signing up for, as opposed to knowing many years after you've had a relationship with a child and many things have gone on. So what do you really think about all of this? Do you think it should be a normal test or do you just think, well, it should only be when there's an issue?
I think that it's should be only when maybe the man wants to do it. Because for me, being with someone, being in a relationship should be based on confidence. You cannot be with someone and already think that the person is going to cheat on you.
So do you agree with DNA testing for babies if there's no suspicion, but just that the guy wants to have a clear mind while he's raising the child, or you do not agree?
I do not agree.
Why?
Because for me, any relationship is based on trust. Doubting the child's paternity means you don't trust at all the woman you call your wife or your partner or whatever. So for me, it's a big N-O, no.
Okay, so let's remove you. So let's agree that maybe your brother feels like his partner might have cheated on him and she's trying to pin the baby on him. Will you support him to carry on with the DNA test and just have a clear mind while he's doing things, or you will still stand firm that no, you do not agree? This is not you now.
This is my brother.
Yes, your brother.
I would say if he doubts his woman, means there's no trust. It's all about trust. So, are they married or not?
Not married.
Not married. Just boyfriend.
Just boyfriend and girlfriend, and then they have a child situation involved.
Oh, for me, if he really doubts her, and then he run the paternity test, he cannot marry this woman again, because there is no trust. Right?
Yes.
So if he wants to test the paternity, he can do it, but I won't agree for him to marry her later on.
Yes. Okay, thank you very much.
Well, thank you for bringing up this really interesting issue. I would say yes and no. First, no, in normal circumstances, because when you are already married, I mean, it's obvious that you should trust your partner. So this is something that should not even, I mean, cross your mind in the normal cases. But you know, on this earth, we have a lot of bad angels. And also it depends on the places, on continents too. And if you have like any doubt, you are free to go. There is no problem on that one. So I think it's your freedom, and it depends on the people. So this is what I really believe. So in your normal circumstances, no. But if you have any doubt, go and do it without any problem. So this is what I really think about that issue.
And do you think it affects the relationship after that? For example, since you've demonstrated that you don't trust this person, do you think you should continue with this kind of relationship after that, or you think that you can go back to being normal?
Well, I think if you are already taking that path, it means that your relationship has already taken a coup. It means that the trust is already damaged. So after that, if you find out that it's not true, Yeah, you can just sort it out and continue that. It depends on the people, it depends on the couple. Yes, the couple can continue living without any problem. Now, it depends on how you started things. And if it happens that you were right, it also depends on you. So whatever the case, whatever the situation where you're going to find, yeah, you can sort it out and continue that relationship.
Okay, so let's assume that you're in a situation and that's the whole thing. Like, you have done the test and discovered that this child doesn't belong to you. So what's the next step you're going to take from
but
there?
But she has cheated on me. She has betrayed me. So now it depends. Then I think I can, because I cannot live with someone who betrayed me. So it depends on me. But if I've been living with children for a long time, yeah, I can take care of the children. It depends on me. But if I think that it has been too much, I will refuse. Yeah, so it really depends on the situation. And it also depends on the number of children.
So let's say, for example, you have three children. Will you ask her to take the children to their father, or you will just continue to raise these children?
Well, this is a hard nut to crack. It's something that you cannot really predict what you are going to do. I mean, like, it's something that you are going to react on the spot. I mean, depending on the case. You cannot say, I will do that. Because there are many variants of the situation that can happen to you that will present. So I will not say, okay, I will take care of the children or not. It will depend on my mind, my mood, the feeling, the interaction I have with children, how we grew up, and even the age, how they take me. Because for sure, someone else's children will never be your child. Huh?
Never. But you've been raising them as your child.
Yeah, you'll be raising them. I mean, also, that's why I said it depends. You can raise them, they can know the truth, but at the end of the day, you know that they are not your children.
So you mean the love will not be the same?
The love is going to impact something. But I know already some couples who have that problem. They didn't go through DNA. But at the end of the day, he found out that the children was not his. But he continued raising the children. Though there is a difference. For sure, it will not be the same.
So let me go through a controversial angle now. So let's say, for example, a woman discovers that these children may not be her children. Mm. So based on the fact that she knows it's going to affect the relationship, do you think it's okay for her to go ahead and tell the man that this is what happened, or should she just let sleeping dogs lie, as they always say?
Well, I think before getting involved, before going far, if you're married, things like that, I think it's always good to tell the truth.
Even though it has repercussions?
It's always good to tell the truth, okay? I think it's always good to tell the truth. Well, that will also depend. But I'm not a woman, but if I'm a man and I've been cheated by someone else, I would like to know, sooner the better. For me to take the right action, because the longer you hide it to me, I mean, the worse the situation is going to be. So I would prefer you to tell me.
Just to sit down just on your own mind and say, I just want to be sure that that's my child. That one,
it shows that you don't trust the person, right?
No, if nothing has triggered anything for me to have any suspicion, I don't see why I should go.
I think that I have to do it.
Really, even though there's nothing, even though the woman has not given you any reason to prove to you
if she had not given any reason, then I see that there's no reason for me to do it. Okay, but if I have the slightest suspicion that, okay, this person might, I'll go and do it.
What I think that will change the world, but the thing is, if you're going to doubt your wife to the extent that you go for a DNA test, even without, you know, signs, as you were saying, then there's no point in you marrying her.
Exactly.
Because the reason I'm saying this is, what about other women who go around cheating on their husbands, but then they try as much as possible not to have children with them? Yes. So you, the man, you'll be there thinking, okay, these are my children, and that's my wife is not cheating on me. It's not a proof. The fact that your children's DNA or your DNA doesn't mean that she's faithful. Yes.
Okay,
and then on the other hand, what about the men who go around cheating?
And they bring children home and the women take care of them.
Yes. So my point is, it's pointless. Whether you trust your wife or not, having a DNA test just to prove that your wife is faithful is pointless.
No, it's, you know, prove that your wife is faithful, it's prove that the children are your children.
And then
just
what?
So you are taking care of your children.
So So what?
What afterwards?
When you find out they are not cheating,
and then what?
You pull out.
You pull out of
not the marriage. Or
not the marriage.
Like, you, whatever love you
have in the church,
or try to have your own child or whatever it is. No,
that is
different.
Will come out.
Yeah.
So, but wait, but you've been raising these children. So how are you just going to pull out? These children have a bond with you. They have a relationship now.
That's why they say you should do it early enough.
How do you think the wife is going to feel about this whole thing?
How do you think it will affect the relationship afterwards?
Yes, how do you think your wife
she should I want you to say she should go for the DNA test.
Yes.
Of course, she will not be happy,
but
it can cause a lot of tension.
It will cause it.
Many, many minutes later.
As I said, it comes down to communication. I'll ask my wife, okay, we talk and we realize that, okay, so for around this particular season, she had been cheated on me. Okay, fine. She accepts. She agrees. I will ask, do you think there's a chance that the child is not mine? If he says, I don't know. Okay, fine. I've built a good relationship with that child. That is what is more important to me.
So to you know go out and know what that's
yes, so
about.
Okay, wait. So the child
you
is
know,
for
and
example,
then what?
I'll not go on to check.
And
I
come
won't.
With your example.
So what? So the child is 15 now, realize he's not your child. What are you going to do?
You don't do now, you just continue that to you. But in your mind, you know that's not your child. That's all.
But you've built a relationship with your child.
I'm not saying I'm not taking care of the child. But in your mind,
for now, I won't be. I don't want it to get the name.
And then, how is the relationship with your wife going to be?
That's what I'm saying. Marriage is beyond childbirth.
It is whether you can forgive or not.
This is the end of the video, but this is definitely not the end of the conversation. So I'd love to read your thoughts in the comment section. Let's continue the conversation in the comment section. Thank you so much for staying tuned with me. See you in the next one. Goodbye.